Welcome to a lesson on the new state's paradox of apportionment. If a new state is added as well as a proportional number of new seats, it seems logical that the number of seats of existing states would not change. However, this is not always the case. Adding a new state with its fair share of seats can affect the number of seats apportioned to other states. When a state gains or loses a seat in this situation, this is called the new state's paradox. The new state's paradox was discovered in 1907 when Oklahoma became a state. Before Oklahoma became a state, the House of Representatives had 386 seats. Comparing Oklahoma's population to other states, it was clear that Oklahoma should receive 5 seats. As a result, the House size was increased by 5 to 391 seats. The intent was to leave the number of seats unchanged for the other states. However, when the 391 seats were apportioned, Maine gained a seat and New York lost a seat. Maine went from 3 seats to 4 seats, and New York went from 38 seats to 37 seats. This is the new state's paradox. Let's take a look at our own example. Let's suppose a certain city has 2 districts, A and B. The populations of the districts were given in the table below. There are 100 police officers that are employed to patrol these 2 districts. Apportion the officers using Hamilton's method. First, notice how the total population is 100,000 and the number of officers is 100. So the standard divisor, as we see here, is equal to 1,000. So to find these quotas here, we divide the district population by 1,000, which is equivalent to moving the decimal point to the left 3 places. For the next step, we remove the decimal part of the quota for the initial allocation or lower quota. So District A receives 10, District B receives 89. But notice how this sum is 99 and we have 100 officers to apportion. So we give the extra officer to the district that has the largest decimal part to its quota. So comparing 0.45 to 0.55, because 0.55 is larger, the extra officer is assigned to District B. Therefore, the final apportionment is 10 officers for District A, 90 officers for District B, giving us a total of 100 officers. Now suppose the city expands to cover a new district called District C. Notice District C has a population that's roughly 5,000, which is a 5% increase from the previous population. As a result, the city hires 5 new police officers to cover the new district, bringing the total to 105 officers. So the population increased by approximately 5%, and the number of officers also increased by 5%. Now we'll apportion the 105 officers using Hamilton's method. To find the standard divisor, we take the total population of all the districts and divide by the number of officers, which is now 105, giving us a divisor of approximately 1,002.381. Let's go ahead and check these quotas here. We take the population of each district and divide by the new divisor. So 10,450 divided by 1,002.381 gives the quota of approximately 10.43 for District B. We have a quota of approximately 89.34, and finally for District C, the new district, we have a quota of approximately 5.24. And now for the initial allocation, or the lower quota, we remove the decimal part. So we have 10, 89, and 5. Notice how this gives a total of 104 officers, but because we have 105 officers to apportion, we apportion the extra officer to the district that has the largest decimal value of its quota. So comparing 0.43, 0.34, and 0.24, notice District A has the largest decimal value. So District A receives the extra officer. So the final apportionment is 11, 89, and 5, bringing the total to 105. Notice if we compare this final apportionment here to the final apportionment when there were only 2 districts, Notice District A went from having 10 officers to 11 officers, and District B went from having 90 officers to 89 officers. This is an example of the new states paradox. I hope you found this helpful.